Hello guys, Tom Quayle here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back again with another review, this time for our quiet room section. And as you can see today, I'm in a slightly different location because very kindly Sound Effects Premier in Ormskirk have loaned us this guitar, a Martin 00015M, and their space as well. So I'm in Sound Effects Premier to shoot this review. So slightly cool, very unusual location. So this guitar is a really nice, affordable, actually high-end Martin, or surprisingly affordable considering how much Martins can go for, with really, really unusual look and construction compared to a lot of the other Martins on the market. The reason being, it's pretty much all mahogany construction. So as usual, let's start up with the headstock end, work our way down and see what we've got. So starting up here, we've got the Martin script logo. Looks really, really nice. Beautiful design, always looks classy on here. Classic Martin headstock with three per side, vintage open gear tuners. So if I turn this over, you can see here, I just love this look. I think it looks fantastic on all Martin guitars or all acoustic guitars. Really, really nice logo. Only bettered by me with a slotted headstock, but in this case, it's a 00, so you don't get the slotted headstock. It's obviously just your basic solid headstock. Now we've got mahogany neck. Finished in satin, feels superb, lovely, lovely feel to this. It's a C shape, very, very comfortable indeed. Certainly not going to cause issues for people with smaller hands like myself. And if we turn back over again, we've got an East Indian rosewood fretboard, beautiful grain on here, lovely black kind of lines running through with vintage sized frets, so no jumbos here or anything. These are definitely vintage sized, which you'd expect on a 00. And we've got very small, subtle abalone inlays on here, which look beautiful. Really, really nice design. Nothing over the top. Again, this guitar is about subtlety. So even though it's an unusual wood construction for an acoustic, in terms of the overall construction, it's not shouting over the top. It's a very, very nicely constructed guitar that's very subtle indeed. As we come up to the body, joining at the 14th fret, the body size is the same as a 00014 fret guitar. So it's a really comfortable standard 00 size and is very, very comfortable to play. And again, very classic and vintage in nature. So the body itself, this is where things get a little bit unusual. This is an all mahogany construction, as I mentioned at the beginning of the review. Mahogany top and mahogany back and sides. Okay, so you can see there, all the same wood. Beautiful bits of mahogany. Mahogany is not a particularly figured wood at all, but you've got lovely bits of black speckling going on through here that really looks attractive. No binding, no purfling, nothing on here. It's just a very, very, kind of basic is the wrong word, but a very kind of classic looking guitar, you know, from that kind of old school Martin kind of look. Nothing really kind of over the top going on here, as I mentioned. Rosewood bridge, as you'd expect. Internally, very simple as well. No electronics, no DIs going on here. It's just your standard Martin guitar. And the beauty of that, of course, is it saves you some money. You're still getting super high-end guitar construction, quality components, very nice bracing on the inside, beautifully clean, so on and so forth. But you're saving some money in terms of the electronics, and then you could, if you wanted to, either mic the guitar up like we're doing here, or you could fit your own pickup system to it aftermarket. Okay, so apart from that, as I say, pretty basic. There's nothing too crazy to talk about here. So you just need to let you hear it. And the guitar itself sounds amazing in the room. Really, really amazing. Crystal clear. So if I play a G chord here, the string to string consistency is very, very good indeed. So if I just play every single string sounds open and, you know, it rings beautifully and cleanly. The sustain is very good. Well, not very good, it's superb, you know, as you'd expect with this kind of guitar. Very comfortable to play, feels good for lead work. Very good indeed. Tuning stability is very good as well. You know, open gear tuners, some people maybe would think they're an old school thing and they're not as consistent. These seem to be very good indeed and they look great as well. Sounds great for strumming. It's a loud guitar considering its size. We're in a very dead sounding room here, so you really get the idea of the dynamic range of this instrument. If I play just some strumming material, What you'll hear is the bass end kicks in beautifully the harder you hit, so you really do get this variation from quite a thin, delicate kind of sound right up to a really beefy, kicked in kind of bass end response. Again, just like hitting a piano really hard, you get more of that kind of bottom end woof, if you like. Very, very tight sound, sounds great, and very nicely in tune all the way up the instrument. So if I'm playing, you know, up here. So again, remains very consistent all the way up the fretboard. So, very, very nice guitar. Eminently affordable for a Martin. It's not going to cost you remortgaging your house or selling a kidney, but you're still getting a very high-end guitar. It's not cheap at all. It's definitely a pricey instrument, but you know, it's that mid-range kind of price for Martin that's kind of more affordable for most people. So definitely something you should check out. Very nice looking guitar. If you want something a little bit more unusual than your standard kind of spruce top, rosewood back and sides kind of acoustic, definitely something to look for. And the mahogany has a really nice tight bottom end, which is kind of unusual and kind of unique, distinct sound as well. So there you have it, guys. That's the Martin 00015M Acoustic. Thanks to Sound Effects Premier for loaning us the guitar and the space, of course. And I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.